Beloved one, a long, long time ago, in a land far, far away, you decided you were going to do something. You, as the one mind that is always going forward creating and experiencing, wanted to know, how would it feel to create? How would it feel to experience creation? How would it feel to experience the creations? So you brought forth lilies, daffodils, daisies, roses, moonbeams, all of the things of beauty, and you knew yourself to be in a garden, a beautiful garden. You looked around and you wondered, what else can I create? Can I have someone who will share this with me? And you did. You created someone like you to enjoy the beauty that you had created and that you kept on creating, the sunrises, the sunsets, everything of nature, everything that you considered to be beautiful, and you were happy. You knew yourself to be the creator of what you were experiencing, what you were seeing, and you knew the other one was feeling the same as you were. There was a rapport, if you will, a sameness of the one mind come forth to experience. Then again there came the thought, what else can I create? So you created the certain life forms that would eat the plants. You experienced being in the creation that you were making, and there came a certain forgetting that you were the one creating, that you were the one who created the tallest trees and the animals which would climb the trees. You created all form, all variations of forms. Then you had another thought. In the competition, can I create something that is stronger than what my friends, by this time you had created other friends, create something stronger, more powerful that can run faster, climb higher, see farther, swim faster. Can I come to a place of the competition where my object can overcome the others? It was still a game. It was still one mind playing within the one mind, and knowing that it was all from the same divinity, the same energy. But as more and more of your attention became fascinated by the creations, there was a forgetting that you were the one who was creating. There was a forgetting that truly there is but one mind, capital M. Sometimes you know the one mind even now. There are times when you tune into each other, and you can tell what the other one is feeling or thinking or planning. You have a feeling, and you wonder sometimes, where did that feeling come from? Where did that thought come from? You may think of someone, and then your technology sounds off and you say, oh, they are on the telephone calling me. You knew, before you even picked it up, who it was going to be, because you still live within the one mind. You do not focus on it, but it is still there. It is still an intuitive power that you have not lost. You know how the mate is feeling. She may not say a word. He may just have feelings, and you tune into them. You know when your friends are having a good day, and you know when they may be trying to have a good day. You can feel, because you are still in the one mind, even if you do not focus or attend to it. Then as the feeling of separation grew, I am separate from you, my creations are separate from your creations, my creations are better than yours, etc. There was a sense of distancing and a sense of competition. You have been living with that feeling for a long, long time, so long that you have almost, but not quite, forgotten that you are creating your reality, lowercase r, that you are creating your experiences, and you are also creating your reactions to your creations. You have taken the knowing of separation now to a certain degree quite far out, so that you now feel separate from the chair that you sit on, separate from the dwelling place that you are in, separate from each other. You have certain personality traits. Your friends have other personality traits. Each one would say, I am unique. I am special, and you are, but there is always the one mind which joins you together, and that has been forgotten. That is what this year is about. There is going to be more light coming forth in this year. The light is going to be showing up the places of darkness. That is why you see so much being mirrored back to you by your news media. They bring you a picture of what is seemingly happening, and it looks very dark. That is because there is more light shining on it. The world happenings seem to be getting darker and darker with more pockets of suffering. In truth, those pockets of suffering have been there a long time, but now the light is shining a bit stronger, and it is showing up the dark places in more clarity. The light that you are is growing stronger every time you have a thought that says, I am the light. Every time you have a thought that says, I believe. I believe that the light is getting stronger, even if you follow it with that very famous saying, Help thou mine unbelief. In other words, I believe, I want to believe, I do believe, but sometimes I need a little bit of help to really believe. That is okay, because you are focusing on the light, and the light is going out and is showing up the pockets of darkness. Whereas before, there was not as much light, and everything seemed more gray, now you have distinct light and distinct dark, and that is why I speak so optimistically of this year, because truly you are making changes. You individually have come to a certain point of wanting change, of knowing that you can make change, and collectively that is happening on the broad scale as well. Ones have suffered enough. Ones are at the place where they want to be relieved of the suffering. As we have mentioned in other times, the ones who seem to be going through suffering are the ones who have volunteered to play that scripting so that there can be a focusing upon what is seemingly happening and what can be changed. They have volunteered to be part of the groupings that seemingly are suffering. Attend to that word, seemingly, because in truth, that is how you are receiving the information that they are suffering. But are they truly suffering? Not really. They are playing a part that they have volunteered to play, and they are doing a very good job of it so that you can see the difference between light and dark, and the light is growing. Now, when we have spoken of separation and of the focus upon whatever you are creating, upon your creations, you have chosen to be in a certain grouping of ones who are seeing much of division, much of separation. Why? Because you have wanted to know, and there is no judgment in this, so hear this well, you have wanted to know, how does it feel to be in an experience unlike love? Because you know, at the basis of you, the very basic element, the very basic, tiny piece as you might see yourself, that you are love. This is your essence. You want to love. You want to be loved. You know that truly that is all there is love. But you have said, for a while, I want to try out what it feels like to be outside of that. So you and some of the other ones, as you call other aspects of yourself, have said, we will play on a planet far, far out in space, a warring planet where ones are in competition, where ones have forgotten how to love. And then ones such as you come along and say, hey, those aren't the rules. I know different rules. I'm not going to play by those rules. And you start changing everything. Then the ones who are seemingly your playmates wonder, what is going on? What has changed? Why has it changed? What page are we on? In other words, in the scripting, what page? Because you are changing things. You have said, okay, I've had enough of this. I have felt unloved long enough. I have felt separate from my whole being. I have felt that long enough. I want to know love. I want to feel love. I want to give love. I want to live in an ocean of love, and you are going to. In this year you are clearing out a lot of the dark. Why? Because you have had it up to here, above the head, with feeling unloved. You have had it. Some of you have had it in the first few years of your lifetime, enough that would do forever, for eons, and you have said, okay, okay, done. I am going to live in love now. I am changing the rules, and you do. You step out of the unloving hologram. Sometimes you are a little bit hesitant, and you say to yourself, well, I want to have a little change, maybe a little change. Okay, I'll do it. And it worked. It was okay. I went up to that person, and I said to them, hey, I'm really glad to see you. And you are thinking on the inside, I hope it's okay to say that, because I really want to live in love, and I don't want something unlike love coming back at me. But I want to try it. Can I really try it? Yes, I can try it. So you bring both feet together, and you say, I'm glad you're here. I have missed you. I have missed having you in my life. I really want to play again as we used to play. At that point, what do you think the light does? It goes on, yes, It extends, and it grows brighter. If there is any part of darkness, it will show up, and then it will disappear. You have a saying in your world that is very, very true, and it is a very good saying to remember, that the darkness cannot extinguish the light of a single candle. A candle flame will always be light. You put it in a dark room. The darkness cannot extinguish that light. That is who and what you are. You are the candle. Remember your light. Let it shine. Smile. Know that truly you have the courage to come forth and to live in light. You have chosen out of great courage to live on a planet far, far away. Far, far away, seemingly, from love, in order to bring your light to it, to play in the darkness and then to be the light of the candle, to shine in love, and to find other ones who want to feel that light as well. And what happens when you get together with other ones who have that light, and they want to play with the light? What happens? It magnifies itself. This year is going to be a wonderful year for you. You are going to be finding more and more light, and that is going to show up more and more darkness. I tell you that ahead of time, because when you see the darkness, do not get into an, oh, my goodness, place. You do not have to be in that place. Know that truly you are the flame of the candle. You are the flashlight that is beaming your light onto everything that may be seemingly dark. It really is not dark. It is just missing its light. So you come along and you shine your light. You do that in the marketplace, and people find what they are looking for. They are looking for love, for acceptance. Go forth in this year. Let your light shine. So be it.